let him speak. Let's show some decorum. You're gonna get your chance. Come.
I look forward to hearing your side, sister. I think also when a man lacks asserting respect or being assertive in general, and a woman is able to run over that man, she ultimately loses respect. And I've seen that time and time over again from my mistakes in my relationships and other men's mistakes in their relationships. And whether the woman admits it or not, I respect. So I think that's something that as men, we need to kind of shield and, uphold, because they're not going to admit that, hey, I need you to be a man, you know, assert yourself. I've never heard a woman say that, but that's truly what they desire.
And at the end of the day, we want you to grow as a man.
She's really eager to speak. Well, so we're gonna hear from you. Let's hear from her, Moshe. She's really eager to speak. So go ahead, Hope. So, what do men do that contributed to women departing?
The only thing that we want for men is to grow. We need you guys to be men at the end of the day.
That's really broad. Can you help me out there? What does it mean to be a man?
So the new way of what the new man has to develop is what? This mommy daycare? Mommy daycare? Take care of the kids?
So you're saying men should be looking after the children? Yes. Is that what you're saying? That's going to put an effeminate spirit on him.
I know. But that's the new way, because we as women, we are the new queens. We are the new kings. Mm. We are the ones who's making the money now.
Mm. So can you, I know a lot of people are hypothetically speaking that, mm-hmm. but when you look at statistics, is that really true? Are women really making more money than men?
Yes.
Okay, can you prove that? Can you cite a source where that's true? Because I find that to be really inaccurate.
Yes.
So let me ask you this: what's the average medium salary of a female?
The average salary is now growing for more women for us to make more money.
Okay, but what is the average salary? What's the average medium salary? Someone want to pull that up? Let me pull that up then real quick.
$100,000 more than what men make.
Because are you serious?
We're the creators.
Okay.
We're the creators.
The children
are the creators, but women are the creators.
Let me say this, Hope. This is not really about men bashing or women bashing. It's about to try and build up. We're trying to find resolutions here.
I'm not bashing anybody.
You don't think your words just play a little favoritism there?
No, I love men.
You just said you're the creators.
We are. We're the creators.
Can you cite your source where
creators of the children? We are the creators.
Okay, let Moshe. Moshe has something to say here. Let Moshe butt in my eye.
Okay.
I just want to say that. Okay, I agree with the brother, Yehoshabi, right? When you were saying that sometimes women, they do get bored at things. Now, the Most High, all praises to Yah, has been showing me things. They came out with another, and I'm with you, sister. I get what you're saying, but I do not agree that the women are solely the creators, because it takes two, and Yah is the creator. And it goes deep, but I don't want anyone to think like she's a, pick me. No, we're trying to come to an understanding. And what the Most High revealed to me, and I also agreed with Jadier about, that sometimes women do get bored. And the communication, men, what I do know about men, because I've been married, but that Elohim separated that marriage. I'm not going to go over it again because I forgive him and I don't want to bash him. But I will say that men want to feel needed. Once a woman makes a man feel like he's not needed, it's like the worst thing that could happen. And I'm not here to bash men. I'm not here to bash women. But there's a problem amongst Yah's people, especially us Hebrews, where the system is already set up to take away our time. a lot of people working for wages. And so that creates a strain. What he showed me recently through the, they came out with a new episode, a season of Sex and the City. And I'm like, this show is still on? Like, this was on back in the 1999. And Elohim spoke to me and said, and this was what messed a lot of women up. And I actually sat back and I rewatched. Now, I don't watch nowadays anything that comes on Netflix and stuff like that, because I try to guard my ear gate, my eye gate. I just recently came back on Instagram just to talk about the wars there. But all praises to the Most High. But I feel like our people are at a state right now where the media and what they intake has such an effect. That show raised many women in the West. We're talking about USA. And in that show, it teaches women that they're way too independent and they get a little out of control. Samantha has sex with like hundreds of people. It's not a good, it raised a lot of young girls as well. I watched that show when I was like 10, so I'm not blaming it solely on the show, but I want to say there's something that kind of went wrong. And I just want to say that we have to have a mutual respect between man and woman. And, you know, and I do agree that putting the nurturing part on the father, it takes away, it does make him, it can have an effect on him. Men are not created to be the nurturers. That's why we have the womb and the breasts, as you can, you know, that's why we have to continuously breastfeed, because they have us bottle feeding now. Many people don't get that, the nurturing part of it, the job of a mother. And so I want to say that fathers, though, can help nurture. You know, it's a balance. Yah is a balance. It's Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 9, I believe it says, do not make yourself overwise. Do not be over wicked. Do not be over righteous. But it says those who avoid both extremes fears the Most High. That's what it is. I think that's what it could, some of it, you know, it's a whole big situation. I could go on and on. This is a broad thing. And I think it does have something to do with the balance being messed up with, you know.
No, women has to raise a man, period. Period.
See, those kind of remarks like that are condescending.
It's well, not condescending.
That's not we building up best, anything, right?
We want the best for our kids. So we want the best for our husbands.
So let me ask the guys then. Period. You said that's not condescending. How many of you guys are motivated by that statement that she just stated, a woman has to raise a man? A woman raises a boy, not a man. So how many of you guys are like really motivated or inspired by the statement that she made, a woman has to raise a man? That was his parents' responsibility. How does that make you feel, Jaidir, Yashabin?
To me, it's not very rational, because how can someone who is not something, a woman not being a man, raise a man?
And so the next thing I would like to go through on that is, like, statistically, that's proven to be, like, very, very ineffective. Because when you go into, like, the prisons, what is it, like 80 to 90%?
90%.
Of the people in prison, I think it's 90% of the inmates was raised by single parents, which was a woman. The suicidal rate is much higher when they're raised by a single mother. Teenage pregnancy is much higher when there's a single mother. So there's a necessity, like the book of Malachi says, to fix it, you got to return the hearts of the fathers to the children and the children to the father. The man needs to be in the equation.
What he's saying is political. What we're saying is you have to raise a man, period. Because a woman is always going to push his man to the furthest degree that you have at the end of the day. When a woman leaves you, you ain't willing to take the next step.
That's not raising a man. That's trying to encourage him to be driven. That's not raising him.
No, you asked the question, and I'm telling you, if she left you, she found somebody better. Because what?
Because it sounds like there's some dishonesty there.
Exactly. And what she said, communication, right? It works both ways.
Correct. But bringing it back to, you know, what
I like to, I like to, I like to, how you raising kids.
So I got you on that. And we do all agree.
And that guess it is what? How you raising your grandma?
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure even how to approach that.
Exactly.
But the things that we do agree on, we do agree communication. We do
in
agree
the middle. Who we do is agree in the middle? Your wife.
Hope, are
why
you?
Why did she leave?
Hope, pardon me.
I'm just being honest.
Are you intoxicated by any chance on this Friday? No.
Not at all. I just have this emotion.
No, we hear it, we see it. It's loud and clear.
Okay. Well, yes. I'm letting you know in between, how do you treat your daughter? How you treat your son? How you treat your grandma? It's how you need to treat your bitch, your wife. Why did she leave?
And because so this is why we gotta have dialogues like this.
Because it becomes apparent why this is necessary. Like that. At the end of the day.
It becomes apparent why this is necessary.
It's not necessary. Treat your kids, treat your wife, and treat your grandma. That's all we're trying to say. I'm just letting you know.
So if I can, I guess, translate and sum that up a little bit.
I wouldn't address that whatsoever. It's not really on topic. Yeah. I'm not sure where she's going with that.
Let her talk.
So again, the topic essentially was, what do men do that contributes to, what is it that a man could be doing so guys out there in the audience could know and not make these mistakes that a man does that would actually contribute to a woman that leaves? And that has nothing to do with her raising him.
It just came to mind. This just came to mind. That when I used to try to say something like, okay, this is the problem, I feel like the ego gets involved. And again, this varies from person to person. This is not all men. This is, you know, we're all individuals. But my problem would be that person would get offended. Like, you know, doesn't want to be told I'm doing something wrong. And that's generally a natural human reaction. But I think it all boils down to what the sister was saying, growing. But what I do agree is I don't think we should, as women, and this was always my thing, I always think we should stick it in there as long as we can. That's an oath and a covenant. And the Most High looks at marriage as a very sacred thing, you know? So I feel like women should hang in there as much as you can.
Take the words.
But if it's getting, you know, kind of crazy where your life is on the line, and you know, that's when it's like, okay, you gotta, you know, leave it to the Most High and make your exit. But
son, daughters, but, and grandmas, put your wife first.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Want someone to treat your mom or your grandma, as exactly. She's saying, or your daughter, yeah, is how you should, as a man, treat your wife, your significant, because it's one flesh, bone of my bone.
She's not gonna leave you.
But Moshe, you brought up an excellent point.